beetje langer geslapen heb. Ik zie mijn stream settings voor deze keer rode error messages. Jullie moeten allemaal net geduldig wees. Ik heb een andere ISP gekregen, dan moet ik net hieruit kom in die lijn van mij kom opstel. Laatste week het ons gepraat, waar het is laatste week gepraat? Ik het nog niet. Hier is zover voorbereid. Episode 21. Ek kan seker hierdie mic draai so wat julle van my kan hoor. Staan stil. Net so. Kan julle nou vir my mooi duidelik hoor? Daai lyk vir my aansienlik beter. Ek gaan eintlik 'n bietjie afdraai. Nee, ek gaan hom net so los. Laasweek het ons gepraat van die eerste vryburgers en die Miller ekspedisie daar waar hulle vir Harry gelos het met al die koper en die tabak en goeie gesê, Harry, gaan jy nou maar? Dan gaan kry jy vir ons beeste in die binnenland en dan kom jy terug. Hulle het so half geverwag dat Harry gaan weghardloop met al die koper en so aan. Maar hulle het nou gelos en hulle word eintlik half toelaat sodat hulle nou finaal ontslaa kan raak van die ou. En so 'n bietjie van 'n spoiler alert, hy kom terug na die fort toe vanaand, maar daar is ook 'n bietjie drama in politiek, actually 'n klomp drama in politiek. Vanaand is baie aksie belaaid met in verband met die diplomatie onder met die kooi onder mekaar. Ons gaan weer eens klomp goed lees. Ek gaan bitter baie leeswerk ook het vanaand. Maar voordat ons daai doen, kom ek sê hallo vir die mense in die kletskolom. Kom ek sit hom daarso. Dan kan ek sê goeie naand aan Brendan Campbell. Everybody from the 313, put your hands up and follow me. Ek dog as die 212. Who the hell let you come to 12? Wie is die 313? Goeie naand Mike Simpson. Ek neem aan Finny Simpson is ook daar in die achtergrond. Naand sê Mike en Finny Simpson. As ook RJJ met sy sexy gouwe kroon. Bebop Williams, lekker boys. Bebop vra waar gaan my Christmas video? Ek weet nie vir een of ander rede het hy gesê ek moet vanaand stream oor die Christmas besigheid. Ek weet nie of my Christmas video nog online is en dit gaan oor, is dit Christmas of Kersfees? Of Christusfees? Daar is Finny Simpson nou, naand sê Klipkop en Maats, goeie naand Finny Simpson as ook ys. Hoeveel sekonde toch? Hy is swart. Dit is verskrikkelijk warm hier so aan die Weskus. Daar is veldbrande in die Stellenbosch area, Franshoek area. Christo D is ook hier so. Drama met aksie, sê jy. Inderdaad. Inderdaad. En dit smaak goed, dit is die hele spanniekie. Dit is baie warm, maar ek het nog steeds vir my jou kopie troos. Een kopie troos gebring, hopelik sal ek nie te warm kry nie. Ek gaan net gauw die telefoon op silent sit. Mense het so'n manier om vir my te tekst op die mees ongelee tye. En ons draf vanaand draf ons die volume 1 van die 3 volume reeks van die dagboek van Jan van Riebeeck. Maak ons vanaand klaar met hom. Hierdie is my gunsteling van gunsteling. Daar fokus hy nou. Boe, kyk die delay. Maak het julle naar. Oe, is my lekker. Toch te lekker. Waar is jou nanas? Ok, ek moet opgespeel. Gaan sy beentjies oopvlek. Kom, ons sit hem hier zo. Gou sy beentjies oopvlek, dat jylle mooi saam met my kan kyk. Waar trek ons nou 16, ons amper by 1656, dink ons nou by 1655 gewees. Hoe is my boek heel omkeerd. Kyk, daar sit hy, heel op die einde. Ons gaan vanaand klaar maak met hom. Ons maak vanaand klaar met hom. Ah, sy! Sit ek vir hierdie oukie hier so neer. draai sy kopiekie plat, dan kan ek hom opsit daar so. Dan moet ek nog net die kameraatjie stel, ek is altyd so mooi voorbereid vir julle. Configure video, dan sê ek by die focus, camera control, by die focus wil ek manual wees, dan maak ek hom so 20, mag maak hom maar 25. Daar kan julle sien, ons het laas week afgesluit met die Müller expeditie. En daar het allemaal nou die Müller expeditie geteken. Hulle het nou vir Harry gelos dat hy aanploeter met die vee na die binnenland toe. Ons kop af hier met Robben Island. Hulle wil een melkkelder op Robben Island bou. Ah, sien julle, ek gaan nou nie in te veel detail ingaan nie. Robben Island, a small milk cellar for bricks. Nou stuur hulle klei en bakstene en so aan om hierdie melkkelder te bou. Ons trek in, ek het nie eens die datum gesê nie. Die 6de Oktober 1655. En hier so is nog meer Robben Island, die melkkelder, as ook weer en landbouskade. Ek het so een of twee goeiekies hier gaan onderstreep. Die mense kan maar na die tyd self daar gaan deurlees as hulle regtig waar belangstel in al daardie goed. Hier sê hulle, today bought it 3 fine sheep from newcomers whom we paid rather generously and treated well in order to encourage them to bring more. It seems to promise well. Ok, het nou seker al gefokus in die bokant van die blad op die 14de hou. Dan weet ek, dit nou die hele blad sê. Ai, fantasties man. As the boat could not carry more than 1,200 bricks and would therefore have to make 3 more trips, it was resolved to send the robbejacht with the bricks and the deck boat with the clay and the aforementioned to the aforementioned island to have it done in one trip. Die robbejacht is ons natuurlijk die bootjie wat hier aan die Kaap gebouw is deur ons eie manne. So daar kan julle sien, die bootjie is dan groter as die klein bootjies wat saam met die ander skepe rol. Daar, ek gaan net vir julle opsit vir die wat wil saamlees. Dit smaak my beguin, dit seker maar die pikke wijn, ek weet nie. Die pikke wijn is een of ander sloepiekie. Ouwe two sloops, robbejacht en beguin. Ek neem maar beguin is pikke wijn. Dalk nie. Die nachtglas skip kom land in die Kaap. She reached the other side of the bay and anchored near the wreck of the Haarlem. Die Haarlem is nou natuurlijk mos die skip waar ons gestop het, waar Jan van Riebeek gestop het, op pad terug na die vaderland toe. Die Haarlem was so 'n jaar hier gewees. Die Haarlem het 'n groot rol gespeel in wat ons, in die rede hoekom ons gekom het hierna. Jy gee hulle 'n subnota, the Haarlem grounded near the present Paden Island. Nou ek weet Paden Island is nie te ver van die middestad af nie. Dit is baie baie naby aan die middestad. Hier sê hulle die aandglas in the company of the Amersfoort, Salmander and Arnhem. Nou die nachtglas het nou hier so opgedag en ons wacht nog vir die Amersfoort, die Salmander en die Arnhem. Ons gaan nou nou van hulle ook lees. Dan vir die mense wat wil saamlees, ek gaan net so bykie laat hy daar focus. Hier praat hulle nog van Saldana en die Robbe. Laat hy nou net mooi daar vir julle ook focus, daar is die story. Vir die mense wat wil na die tyd saamlees, hier kom die Arnhem nou aan. Die Arnhem het opgedaag en sy het omtrent 60 siek aan boord gehad, dis nogal 'n klomp. Only 6 men had died in the voyage. Maar net 6 mense. Ok, ek spring 'n bietjie oor hierdie, want hier kom nou 'n klein huisie vol leeswerk. Nou, hulle het oorgegaan na Robben Island toe. Nou, hulle het so half die kelderkie gebou en so aan. En hier sê hulle, milking of the sheep did not appear to go well. We therefore immediately sent the sloop back there with the following letter. So hulle wil nou kaas ingoed, bok kaas op Robben Eiland gemaakt het. Maar toen sien hulle, wacht, hierso is een probleem. Ek gaan nou vir julle, hierdie is die briefiekie wat hulle vir die mense op Robben Eiland geskryf het. We therefore immediately sent the sloop back with the following letter. Whereas we learn from the gunner's reports that very little is apparently being gained by milking the sheep and that the lambkins are also much retarded in their growth by having their milk withheld. Whereas we consider the rearing of sheep to be of much greater importance to the honorable company than the delicacy of sheep's cheese, you shall on receipt hereof immediately suspend the milking and allow the lambs to have their mother's milk as not to hinder their growth. Daar het ek so 'n klein notaatjie aan die kant gemaak. Dis 'n goed beredeneerde. Is het goed beredeneerde of is het goed beredende? Laat my asseblief weet in die kletskolom, is het beredeneerde of beredende? Daar is die einde van die briefiekie. Daar word kinders gedoop hier in die onderkant, julle kan saamlees daar na die tyd as julle wil. Hier is nog informatie van die Arnhem, ek het 'n bietjie gaan onderstreep. They reported to us that the bowsprit, dit is die, ek het dit gaan Google, die boegsprit, dit is die, die punt op die boot, daar is gewoon ook so'n lang stok wat daar uitsteek, waar hulle die seile in goed vastmaak, jy het die boegsprit nodig om 'n groter oppervlakte te kry vir jou seile, dit laat toe dat jy groter seile op 'n klein bootjie kan sit. That the bowsprit of the Arnhem was found to be so badly damaged in two places that they feared that they would be unable to proceed with it on the voyage to Batavia. It was accordingly resolved by the council of this fortress, strengthened by the ship's officers, to have the bowsprit inspected more closely early tomorrow morning. In elk geval, hulle is nou besig met skepe regmaak. Jy weet, dis groot werk, dis nie klein werk is nie. Ek het verder geonderstreep hierso. After full discussion and consultation, it was resolved by the commander and the ship's officers to repair the bowsprit with side pieces in the manner described, thereby obviating the loss of the time entailed by fitting a new one, whereby the voyage to India would be greatly retarded. Okay, so hulle gaan hom net patch, hulle gaan nie 'n nuwe ene opsit nie. Hier kom 'n Engelse skip in die baai in. Hulle het nogal baie geskryf oor hierdie Engelse skip met die naam van Love. Okay, ons weet nou nog nie die skip se naam is Liefde nie. Towards noon they arrived in the roadstead an English ship, at any rate so it appeared from the flags. She is quite a big vessel with three boats, but no one came ashore today. We do not know what it may portend. We therefore set a closer watch for the night, also along the beach at the Rideau Deinwoop at the Salt River, so that in the event of her being a Portuguese under English colours, intending to surprise us during the night, we could, if at all possible, prevent them from landing. Nou ek het nou nie geweet, hulle is in oorlog met die Portugese ook nie, maar ons gaan nou bietjie meer daarvan lees. Ons gaan nou een bietjie meer, daar praat hulle van Francisco Barreto de Menezes, in alle rande, sulke type goeikies. Ek is seker van julle sal dit interessant vind. Ek het nou nie daar gaan onderstreep, hier kom nog 'n groot leestuk van my aan. The aforementioned English ship sent one boat to fetch water and another to the Salt River to catch fish. Although none of the ship's officers have appeared at the fort or approached the commander to ask the necessary permission. Ja nee, wrachtig, jy moet permissie gevra word om te kom visvang in die Kaap. For the time being, however, we are tactically allowing this without interfering. We gathered from her boat's crew who came to fetch water that she was de liefde. More than 60 men, at least half of whom were Netherlanders. So ja, dit, as nou daar lees, half of whom were Netherlanders. Nou, ons is nou supposed to be die afstammeling van die Hollanders, en ons is supposed nou om die Britte te haat, maar kan julle sien tot in 1655 was daar Engelse boot en die helft van die bemanning was Hollanders gewees. Het ek nou alles gister dat julle ook kan lees na die tyd. Ek hoop maar hy fokus nou mooi. Hier sê hulle, the skipper and the merchant of the English ship came ashore at midday. Hou kom vra hulle nou permissie uiteindelik. They had heard that our people had captured 3 rich Portuguese ships. The officers of the ship have at their request been provided with some garden produce as refreshments for their entire crew. They were also so well entertained at the commander's table that in the evening they returned to their ship full of good cheer without having had a chance to look around much. So dit smaak my, Jan wil nie hê die Engelse moet sien wat gaan hier in die Kaap aan nie. Dit is information disclosure. Hy wil so min as moontlik informatie vir die Engelse gee. Op die 29ste Oktober 1655. In the afternoon, ek gaan net hierdie kamera se fokus 'n bietjie terugstel. Iets is nie lekker hier nie. Configure video, hy's nou op 25, stel hom weer af na 20 toe. Moet kyk of dit help. Ek dink hy lyk beter. In the afternoon, we sent our letter for our lords and masters on board the Englishman, ready to sail with the first favorable wind. They promised to deliver it safely. Sien, daar vat hulle vir ons briefiekies ook aan. Fine weather and wind at Supra, preventing the English ship from setting sail. She had many unwilling hands on board, especially Dutchmen. All 30 or 40 of whom would have liked to remain here. Daar gee hulle nog so 'n bietjie informatie oor die Hollanders wat op die skip was. Julle kan maar na die tyd self daar gaan deurlees as julle graag wil. Maar dit smaak met die Hollanders op die Engelse skip wou graag gebly het. Hulle wou graag gebly het. Die 4de November 1655. Hier kom die ander skip nou in. Die Salamander had also drifted off the course somewhat and been to the Saldanha Bay and Dassen Island. Dis maak my die skipie was 'n bietjie deur mekaar gewees en hulle het sommer in Saldanha geloop stop. Maar hulle is nou by die regte plek. Ek gaan net daar los dat hy mooi fokus, dan kan julle maar na die tyd gaan lees. En dan kom die Amersfoort ook hierso aan. Ek het nou nie hierso gaan onderstreep hoeveel is oorlede nie. Ek dink nie. Presumed to be the Amersfoort. Oké, okay, julle kan maar daar gaan deurlees as julle wil. Ek wil graag by die diplomatie uitkom. Ek spring 'n bietjie oor hierdie goed. Hier sê hulle net many sick on board and needed water. Nou volgende kom daar nog 'n skip aan, die Slot van Honingen. Nou die Slot van Honingen lost only one man during the voyage. So hier het nou baie skepe hier so aangekom. Ek het eers gaan onderstreep toe hulle weer gewaai het. The unmanageableness of the aforementioned ship Amersfoort. Dis maak my hierdie skip het ook herstelwerk nodig. Dan praat hulle oor die weakness of the bowsprit. Dan is natuurlik nou die volgende skip wat ook daardie probleem gehad het, as ook Google Translate sê vir my, dis die roer van die skip, die rudder. in ieder geval die ruur en die boogspriet het herstelwerk nodig gehad. Maar ek gaan ook net so vir julle daar so sit. Ek is seker baie van julle sal hierdie informatie baie interessant vind. En dit is actually, dit is nogal interessant om te lees, maar dit is vir my nie so interessant dat ek my stream 'n uur wil verleng net vir dit nie. In die volgende skippie, die West-Friesland. Hier sê hulle, hoekom is hierdie ding, sy beentjie gee in, dis hoekom. Nou lyk het beter. Also called at the Saldanha Bay, dis maak my die mense is dronk daar op die skepe. Hulle dalk 'n bietjie te veel arak gedrink. Almal stop by Saldanha Bay, hulle ry die Kaap mis. Arriving here with only 2 or 3 sick, ja, hulle daar voels in eieres en goed het hulle gevang daar so. En sommer dag eet, hoe raak die mense sommer gesond. Die robbejag returned safely from the Saldanha Bay. Nou hierso is nou 'n briefiekie wat hulle geskryf het oor toe hulle nou teruggekom het van Saldanha Bay af. Ek gaan dit net mooi daar los vir die mense wat wil saamlees na die tyd. Daar eindig die briefie van Saldanha Bay af. Daar praat hulle ook van die skepe wat per ongeluk daar kom stop het. Hier kom ons nou by diplomatie in. En hier is 'n klein stukkie hieronder wat 'n paar mense hard gaan trigger.
Towards evening, we heard from our forest workers that at least 4 parties of Hottentots with cattle had encamped at various places behind the Table Mountain, about 1 to 1.5 miles from here. Op die 19de November 1655, weather and wind as yesterday, we sent a sergeant with some soldiers to the Hottentots to see who they were, whether any trade could be done with them, and where and how their camps were situated, etc. On their return, the soldiers confirmed the report received yesterday from the woodcutters, and also reported that the said Hottentots had given them to understand that many more natives would come from the interior tomorrow or the day after with cattle, some of which they said they would wish to sell to us. Meanwhile, the Kaapans have also appeared here with their cattle, placing their camp between the fort and the other natives and requesting permission to shelter under our protection. We replied that they would have to remain far enough from our land to prevent the pastures for our cattle from being consumed by their cattle.
Nou maar daar het julle dit. Ek gaan dit gou hier op die kant sit. En 'n slukkie, dis nou 20 oor. Ek gaan nou begin 'n baie hard lees. Klip hard lees. Kyk hoe maak die koffie my sweet. Ons sit die kamera, mikrofoon 'n bietjie uit die pad uit. Daar's so 'n paar bombshells in vanaand se episode. Ek kan vir julle beloof, gaan baie opwindend wees. Ek het net gedink die ouwe lijnstukkie is verskrikkelijk snaaks. Wel nie snaaks nie, maar ek kan imagine die comrades sal nie baie van daardie stukkie hou nie. Wat het ek gemis? Ek het gesien Shack Dwell het ook ingekom. Ek moet 'n sigaret laat, anders is ek weer heel aand besig. Nou moet ek rook en kom en drink is my koffie klaar. Ek sê julle wat, ek gaan die musiek aansit, julle my nie kan hoor sluk nie. Daai was nou heerlik geweest, inderdaad. Mense, kyk hoe sweet ek.
Kry my jammer toch asseblief. Ek dan verskriklik hard vir julle voorgeberei vanaand. Ok. Kom ons sit hem gauw weer hier op die kleedskolom. Finny Simpson sê kom druk die like knoppie. Domina Morgul sluip in. Ja, Domina Morgul, jy moet ongelukkig vanaand heel achter in die kerk sit, omdat jy laat was. Christo D.C. beredeneerde is die correcte spelling, of die correcte uitdrukking. Beredende klink vir my ook so halfreg, maar beredeneerde is vir my, weet, ek as 'n leek sal dit beter verstaan. As iemand vir my sê beredende, sal ek so 'n bietjie dink, maar beredeneerde beteken net daaroor geredeneer. Maar ek sien altyd, jy weet, goed beredeneerde instruksies van onze Jan af. Mense, ek gaan hierdie ruit 'n bietjie oopmaak. Dit is verskriklik warm. Verskriklik warm. Ek kan nie, ek het eers die temperatuur gekyk, ek weet nie hoe warm dit is nie. Dit is nou nog nie Kalahari warm nie. Maar warm is dit definitief. Hier so 'n bietjie oopmaak. Hoopelik kom daar 'n liggietjie deur. Hoe was julle naweek gewees? Ja, hier kom so effens 'n luggietjie hier deur. Nou gaan die bure my net hoor terwyl ek vir julle Jan van Riebeeck lees, maar hulle kan maar kom saam luister. Hulle kan maar met liefde kom saam luister. Bietjie leer oor ons kultuur en geskiedenis. Uit die perd se bek uit. Bebop Williams sê die Christmas video is net 30 sekondes. Dit was nogal 'n interessante video gewees daai. Ek sien Shaq Dweller het vir hom ook 'n kroon aangeskaf. Dankie dat jy ook 'n member is. 'N member geword het. Shaq Dweller. Een van die dae is jou kroon ook so sexy dat hy goud is soos Anti-Marxist ZA en RJJ. Ek sien en die Max het uit ook ingesluip. Klein bietjie laat. Ek het die latency van die chat so 'n klein bietjie afgestel. Hulle sê dit help glo vir die video. Vir die video kwaliteit. As die video kwaliteit beter is, weet net dat julle messages nog 'n paar ekstra sekondes later gaan inkom. Ek het gesien Cyril Ramaphosa praat vanaand 8:00. Ek dink hulle het gesien ek livestream vanaand en hulle het gebesef die informatie wat vanaand gaan uitkom gaan nie pas by hulle narratief nie. Toe maak hulle nou dat die president praat om vir my te blok. Moet julle nie worry nie, julle is op die regte plek. Ek wonder of ek in my livestream so story moet verander na listen to President Ramaphosa speak. Mense, hierso is bitter baie leeswerk vir my vanaand. Ek het nou gespring oor November, maar hulle gaan nou bladsye en bladsye skryf. Alles oor diplomatie met die kooi. Ons diplomatie teenoor hulle, as ook hulle onder mekaar. Swanepoel Design is ook hier, so goeie naand Swanepoel Design, dankie dat jy ook gekom inskakel het, jy kom vang ons nou gedurende die smoke break. Ek moet nog vir my smoke break muziek kry. Hier so na 20 oor is eers 'n smoke break en dan begin ons ernstig lees.
Ja, ek is ook destijds so stil en om 'n pause praat. Ek wacht nou maar dat die ontploffing gebeur op Twitter. Ek sê altyd, daar's geen skaamte om jou kop uit jou gat uit te trek. Nou, maar ek was ook op die stadium gewees, elke keer as die president praat of iets gesê het, maak ek, man, 'n moerse boehaai daaroor. Maar ek het later aan het besef, ek is net besig om die vuur te stook. En al die mense wat so 'n boehaai maak oor wat die president sê, en die type goed, is nou maar net allemaal wat skarrel vir hulle ou geldjie, vir hulle klik, vir hulle like, vir hulle comment. En julle kan maar vir hulle gaan sê, ook ek het so gesê, want hulle weet is waar. Ja, ek glo en vertrou, hulle sal die hoogtepunte kry. Maar dan ek weet, ek luister nie eers meer nie. Ek weet, ons het absoluut geen beheer nie. Hierdie toespraak en goed, ek min, die geraas wat jy maak op Twitter, gaan absoluut niks verskil maak aan wat gaan gebeur. Hulle kyk uit na hulle eie belange. Swing van die windpomp, Sherry. Ok, 3, 2, 1, dag gaat ons. Ons trek nou, nou is nou gepraat het van ouwe land, ons trek nou al hierby einde November. Nou hierso is nog so 'n bietjie goedjies wat julle kan saamles as julle wil. Ek wil oorspring na diplomatie. Nou hier begin die groot leeswerk nou. Ek wonder of ek nie hierdie kameraatjie nog 'n bietjie moet stel, dat hy net gemakkeliker lees. As ek hom so druk, ok, net om seker te maak, ons nou by die regte datum, ons is nou by die 22ste November 1655. In the afternoon, the forest workers brought news that large numbers of natives had come with much livestock. Since the day before yesterday, we have obtained by barter more than 50 sheep here at the fort. We are hoping that it will continue to go well. We have been rather generous and have entertained the natives well in order to entice them more. At the same time, however, we are keeping a good and stronger watch in view of the very large numbers of natives. Shortly before evening, the wind being from the south-southeast, the galliot Nachtglas set sail for the purpose mentioned. May the Almighty grant her a safe and successful voyage. The huntsman informed us that fully 1,000 huts had been put up in the neighborhood and that the cattle were as numerous as the grass on the field. Okay, by subnota 2, the large tribe which now arrived with great herds and flocks was the Koch o Kwas, Koch o Kwas, Koch o Kwas, Koch o Kwas. Ek gaan het so uitspreek. Koch o Kwas. Daar klink vir my die beste, Koch o Kwas. Yesterday the huntsmen had been driven away by the natives, some of whom advanced towards them with assegais, so that they had fired at random over the heads of the natives. Nou hier is nou die tweede keer dat ons gehoor het dat daar gebeur gevuur word bo oor die koeise koppe. The natives thereupon fell flat on the ground while the huntsmen crossed the river to this side and escaped. It seemed that they do not like our huntsmen to shoot the birds. They have now finished hatching and have many young as they want them for themselves. In the morning, calm, clear, sunny weather. Two Hottentots who know some Dutch and daily fetch woods for the cooks came to warn us that we should not allow the huntsmen to go out again in the direction where the Saldanhas are, camped in large numbers, as the Saldanhas had threatened to kill them
because they had fired their guns yesterday and had hit some of their cattle. When questioned about this, the huntsman said that they had fired over the heads of the natives into the air and could not have hit any cattle. Instructions were given, however, that they should go in another direction and shoot partridge, rock rabbits, and other game instead of geese and ducks. But as the natives are walking and running about all over the place, little game will be obtainable and we shall have to make use of the bartered sheep instead for the table to entertain the ship's officers. We would have preferred to keep the sheep and to stock the Robben Island well, so that as a result of increasing by breeding, we could the sooner live without anxiety and without being dependent for supplies on the trade with the natives. In order to achieve this, the natives have been more liberally entertained and a high price paid for their cattle, so as to encourage and entice them the more. En daar is nou so 'n klein stukkie oor Robben Eiland. Hulle het nou 'n klomp skape oorgevat. Hulle het 'n klomp skape gekoop en al die skape gaan oor Robben Eiland toe. Hulle raak mooi vet daarso. Op die 24ste November 1655, in the morning, calm, dark, misty weather, clearing up before noon. With a soft westerly breeze, the commander Riebeeck and the honorable Frisius, having heard of the multitude of natives and cattle hereabouts, went out on horseback. Byt net gou vas, mense. Byt net gou vas. Ek is nou weer met julle. The commander Riebeeck and the honorable Frisius, having heard of the multitude of natives and cattle hereabout, went out on horseback, accompanied by a few armed soldiers, to inspect things with their own eyes. When they had gone a little beyond the Rideau Duinhoop, they found the country so full of cattle and sheep, for half a mile wide and as far as the forest, situated fully 3 miles from here, where our men are stationed. So dit smaak met die hele Noord-Kaap. Sofie is omtrent hierso. That it was difficult to make any progress. The cattle had continually been to be driven out of way by the Hottentots. Otherwise it seemed impossible to get through. Not only the number of cattle, but even the herds seemed innumerable. Likewise, the people who were so curious to see us, that in the twinkling of an eye, we were surrounded by so many that we could scarcely see over them from our mounts. Dit smaak my almal die hele spul van, ek weet nie waar oor is nou hier aan die Kaap. We estimated their number, old and young, to be fully 5,000 or 6,000 people, and the erected huts about 400 or 500. Dis omtrent so 10, 11, 12 persone per hut. These were quite large and placed closer to one another, close to one another in circles, within which the cattle were kept at night. One would with difficulty go round the encampment in half an hour. It appeared to be a formal camp. The carpens were also there with their huts and cattle. Het ek nou 'n stuk gemis? Nee. Also a certain tribe, the captain of which had visited the fort the evening before our cattle were stolen, we had noticed before that they were allies of the Karpmans, and that they also been a party to the theft. Sooner or later, when revenge and indemnification have been decided upon, our object will be to attack this faithless crowd as well as the Kaapmans, as they are so rich in cattle and, like the Kaapmans, are always unwilling to trade. We suspect that they are the chief cause why the other natives being so few bring so few cattle to us. Today we procured only 2 sheep with their lambs. We only found that the natives prefer us to come to them with copper and tobacco for bartering, which for various reasons and difficulties, in view of our experience in the past, would be inadvisable. It is necessary to entice them to the fort under our own protection, where, indeed, they may come without fear. But as they bring so little to us, we fear that they would try to take our men by surprise for the sake of the copper and tobacco they have with them. Some new Hottentots accompanied us to the fort and were treated amicably and well to arrack, bread and tobacco. We requested them to bring some cattle and show them diverse quantities of copper and tobacco, whereupon they appeared to promise to do so. Whether we shall have any success, time will show. Nou hier praat hulle nou nog van die skepe. Ek gaan 'n bietjie oor die skepe spring en aangaan met die diplomatie met die koi. Today we bartered 8 sheep and 3 head of cattle from the natives. Daar kom die beestekies nou in. And should have obtained more had not the Kaapmans interfered by pretending to be brokers and taking a large quantity of copper and tobacco from the others, professedly by way of brokerage, with such rudeness and violence as to cause great disgust among the Saldanha men and make them adverse to trading. Okay, so ons weet nou, die groot groep waarvan hulle nou praat, word na hulle verwys as Saldanha men. Saldanha men. Saldaners. En die Kaapmans maak nou soos wat hy die gemaak het back in the day. Hulle probeer die story boycott en hulle kom sê ja, maar as ons nie hier was, sou dit nie gebeur het nie. En ons kort ons stukkie. En dit maak maar hulle laat die Saldanha mans betaal. As ons vir hulle koper en daai tipe goed gee, dan kom die Kaapmans en sê ja, maar ons moet van daardie koper kry. Op die 27ste November 1655, a new moon, the same bright weather and wind as yesterday. In the afternoon, the sergeant was sent out with some men to see and count the number of Hottentot huts in the immediate neighborhood and to ascertain whether the natives would prefer to trade at their huts rather than here at the fort. On their return, they reported that they had counted exactly 200 huts, quite large, at the Fresh River, and had found that the natives were not eager to trade. The Kaapmans and the tribe of the Black Captain. Nou wat sê hulle van die Black Captain? The Black Captain was Gonema, chief of the Kochokwas. Ek hoop ek spreek dit reg uit. The Black Captain, chief of the Kochokwas. He was so called because he smeared his body with soot. Zwarte Piet. The Black Captain is Zwarte Piet. Kan julle nou meer? Who, as aforementioned, had a hand in the robbery of the company's cattle. We encamped in the midst of them all. They had a multitude of cattle and sheep with them, besides about 40 or 50 huts 2 miles further along below the forest. Today, however, no more than 8 sheep were bartered from them and no horned cattle at all, no matter how much we offered and how generously we treated them.
Nou, hierdie volgende stukkie gaan oor Saldanha. Julle kan sien daar die robbejag en die pikke wyn. Hulle praat weer van daardie. Op die 29ste November 1655, in the morning rather wet rainy weather and northwesterly wind off the sea continuing throughout the day. Today we obtained by barter 13 fine head of cattle and 7 sheep. Nou, dis nou a mooi klompie beeste hulle gekry het. We also received news that Harry was on his way back with cattle and sheep for the honourable company obtained in the interior, and that he would be at the fort in about 8 or 10 days. Time with many other natives, who are also coming to trade with their cattle. Time will show how much success we shall have. Op die heel laaste dag van November, the same northwesterly wind as yesterday, but without rain. Today obtained by barter 16 old and young beasts and 20 sheep. So die vee kom nou mooi in. Some of Harry's Hottentots came to request some tobacco on his behalf. They brought a knife with a brass handle as proof that the message came from him. Recognizing the knife, we sent him some tobacco. They said he would shortly be here in person with many head of cattle obtained for the honorable company. When we inquired from Harry's men about a certain Madagascar slave Anthony, who has been missing for a long time and whom Harry had promised to return to us, they replied that he had been devoured by wild animals. We, however, think that he has been murdered by the Kaapmans. Nou ek weet, toe die gatkryper in charge verburg, hy was mos Madagaskar toe gewees, en hy daar so mooi gemaak met die koning. Ons het laatst keer daar tyd ook so al beginne spekuleer, dat dit is heel waarskynlik van daar af daar die koning wat die slaaf gegee het, en saam teruggestuur het na die Kaap toe. En het lyk vir my, want hulle sê nou hier spesifiek, a Madagascar slave. En dit is die einde van November. Ek dink, dis nou tyd vir nog een smaakbreik, en dan doen ons gauw. Dit gaan nie gauw wees, die mense is nog baie leeswerk. Hier is nog baie leeswerk. Dan doen ons December. Kom, ek laat gauw een eentje. Ou Ramapokrinbakkie gaan net lockdown extend. Ek is anyway stuck in my huis. Brendan Campbell sê lockdown gaan nooit eindig nie. Ek dink Brendan Campbell slaan die spyker op sy kop. Ja, want die third wave kom. Daar kom nog 'n fourth en 'n fifth wave. Wag julle net. 10-year lockdown as jy die IRR glo. Tomina Morgul geef ons prentjies van koeie en skape en so on. Ons, hier is nou een klomp koeie en skape wat actually inkom. Naand en al die rode trieter is ook hier, so my genade aarde, welkom rode trieter. Oeh! En RJJ gee vir ons ook 'n bietjie emojis. Ek dink hy verwys spesifiek na die slaaf wat glo gedevouer is deur wild animals. Deur wilde diere verslind. Daar is hy nou. Nou praat ons Afrikaans. Ek kan nooit verstaan nie, in die een boksie wys hy vir my 16 concurrent viewers, in die ander boksie wys hy vir my 9 concurrent viewers. Ek is baie die mekaar. Ek neem aan dit is seker maar 16, ek sal my positief daarover dink. Ek moet net onthou, ek moet by December begin en nie weer van November is goed aan weerlees nie. Oeh, 11 kilobits per second, 0. Ek moet my ISP change. Ewe skielik, spring hy weer op. Ek sien net rooi ligte flikker hier aan my kant. Een van die dae is my internet beter, hoop ek. Hoop ek. YouTube lieg oor alles. Nou waaroor lieg hulle nog? Die corona. Dit nog so effentjies lig, maar ek kan sien dit is nog nie piknag nie, is amper piknag. Ek kan nog effentjies die buitelug sien. Ek neem aan die video het nou klaar getatte, bye bye. Ek gaan weer die venstertjie oopmaak. Ek sweet myself dood hierso. Trippe, trappe, troone, varkies in die bone, koeikies in die klaver, skapies in die haver. Ek wens dat Sienkie groter was, om al die dierkies op te pas. Elon Musk kom met sy Starlink. Ek volg nie die ou nie. Wat is 'n Starlink? Vandag moet jy 'n masker dra om by 'n winkel of by die werk in te gaan. Volgende haar, seker jaar, moet jy op jou app 'n groen QR-code hê. En jy moet ingeënt wees om hom groen te kry. Conquering Lions die corona is die geelgriep. Is dit geelsig? Net nie die rooi knoppie druk nie. Like, stats, subscribers, hoeveel lede. John Woest, nadele kom nou eers by die huis aan, sal weer opvang. Die deur die week. Ja, die is nog een paar interessant, val oor die weer, hier is een paar stikke waar hulle praat van hoe ek denk dat graan gewas, stikkend geslaan is deur die weer, en geverwaai is, is meestal wind, wat hulle grootste probleem was. So een paar duisend satelliete wat low latency, high bandwidth internet sal lever. Ja, wel as dit bekostigbaar is, ek meen, sign me up. Maar op die oomblik is satelliet internet nie baie bekostigbaar nie. Ok. Ons is amper daar. Oeh, my lyf. Dan gaan ons na December 1655 toe. Ok, let's go. Ek gaan dalk net hierdie ding 'n bietjie groter trek, want ek kan beter sien. Waar stel 'n mens om? Ha, sê. Nou kan ek ook beter lees. Ons is nou in December 1655. Val die sigaret as. We gathered from some Hottentots that they had seen two ships in or near the False Bay. They could not tell us whether these were lying at anchor or were sailing. Ek sien John Woest het 'n R35 sticker vir my gestuur. Baie, baie dankie vir jou ondersteuning, John Woest. Dit word waardeerd. John het my een pakkie eentjes gekoop. Of so 'n bietjie bygelas van my nuwe internet. Ek kan nie wag dat die ding hier so kom nie. Kan ek miskien vir julle beter livestreams gee?
We sent out 3 good soldiers this morning to the said bay. If they found nothing there, they were to return along the coast towards the Hout Bay to see if they found anything there or anywhere out at sea. Today we obtained by barter 9 head of cattle and 8 young and old sheep. Sien hulle, hier kom die vee nou een na die ander in. Daar sal in die geskiedenisboeke, in die offisiële curriculum van die geskiedenis wat hulle in die skole leer, word daar geleer dat die mense hier het geweier om vee aan ons te verkoop. En dit is absoluut bullshit. Hulle het vee aan ons verkoop. 'N klomp ook. Maar dit het nie baie, jy weet, gereeld ingekom nie. Dit was 'n klomp op een slag en dan ewe skielik is daar niks vir 'n lang tyd nie. So daar is 'n bietjie fake news wat in die skole versprei word. Towards evening it began to rain heavily, continuing throughout the night and on the second in the morning, with fairly strong northwesterly winds. Today 1 beast and 12 sheep were obtained. Op die 3de December 1655, much rain and northwesterly winds blowing quite strongly, surprising for this time of year.
Alright, hier gaan ons nou weer dik in die diplomatie in. Nou moet julle sien hoe gaan ons met die vee.
Today the Hottentots came to depasture all their cattle near the fort. The land between the Salt River and here, and right up the slopes of the mountain, swarmed with cattle and sheep. At a guess, well over 20,000 head. Yet from the vast multitude we could obtain no more than 3 young and old cows and 7 sheep. In spite of the high prices offered and the good entertainment given to the natives. We therefore inquired from a certain Hottentot, known to us as Klaas Das, who has learned to speak a little Dutch and is acting as interpreter in Harry's absence, why these natives offered so few cattle for sale in view of their desire for copper and especially their liking for tobacco. In reply, they gave us to understand that these folks were not anxious to part with their cattle, but that within a few days Harry would be coming along with other people and still more cattle of which we could get as many as we desired. Over and above those Harry had already obtained for the Honourable Company and was bringing with him. These natives here would be departing as soon as the weather improved, as Harry was coming with other people who could then occupy the pastures in this neighborhood. Further question as to why these people would make room for the others, Klaas Das said it was because Harry would be bringing along people to whom they would see. Harry would be bringing along people to whom they could see that we were friendly disposed. They would therefore not wish to hinder him, but seek to oblige him as much as possible, in order also not to evoke our anger. When asked whether those coming with Harry were enemies of these here, he said no, but that sometimes disputes arose between them, and that they then took each other's cattle and killed one another. But they soon made peace again. It is quite obvious that a lively little war must have taken place now and then, judging by the terrible scars and wounds which cover the naked bodies of many of them. Also by the fact that the Kaapmen sometimes have but few and then again many cattle, of which they say they were robbed and they in their turn rob others again. So dis die Wille Weste hier aan die Kaap, in die Kaapgebied. At noon the aforesaid 3 soldiers returned, reporting that they had not seen ships or anything else. Rainy weather continuing, a wind mainly west-southwest, veering more and more to the south.
Ooh.
Hier is ons die groote nou. Today we had an excellent day in cattle trade, having obtained 52 head of cattle, young and old, and 21 sheep from some other natives just arrived, who promised to bring more tomorrow. If they bring as many again, our supply of copper plate will be completely exhausted. Dit gaan een probleem is, want Harry is dan nou nog op pad met nog mensen, wat wil kom vee koop, hoe gaan hulle maak as hulle nie koper plaat het he? But we trust that we may be able to persuade them to take the copper wire instead, though they do not esteem it so highly. Our second interpreter, Klaas Das, also stated that the said natives had intimated that they would come with so many beasts for sale that our supply of copper would become exhausted, so that they could have the pleasure of laughing at the commander. So far as the copper plate is concerned, this would not take long to bring about, but nevertheless, it is something to be wished for. A goeie probleem om te hê, inderdaad. Whether the news will prove to be so good, time will show. We can only hope so. Sondag die 5de December 1655. Stormy, wet, rainy weather, wind westerly. Almost the same as on the previous days, the natives came again to depasture thousands of cattle and sheep in the vicinity of the company's fortress. We were obliged to close our kraal, or a large number would have come in of their own accord. We were forced to request them to keep their cattle somewhat further away from the fort, which they did. Today they sold us 15 beasts, young and old, and 6 sheep. In the evening we received news from the Hottentots that Harry was quite near with his camp and cattle and would probably be here tomorrow or the day after with some cattle for us and a few for himself. Op die 6de December 1655. In the morning, fine calm weather and variable breeze. Had the skins discharged from the robbejacht to be dried and to have the boat ready for carrying sheep across to Robben Island. Today we bartered 27 head of cattle and 18 sheep from the natives. And this evening we sent the robbejacht with 68 sheep to the Robben Island. Ons moet nou al 'n klomp vee weer hê. Ons gaan nou 'n telly weer kry. Also received news from our woodcutters that the large troop of Hottentots with all their cattle had broken camp and were leaving for the Cape Falls. The Kaapmans remaining at the forest at the foot of the mountain, and also that Harry would be arriving within 2 or 3 days with other natives and cattle. Ek hoop hulle het nog koper plaat vir hulle. In the morning, fine, calm, favorable weather, we therefore dispatched the small sloop Pegoine to the Robben Island with 28 sheep, leaving a good load to be sent on per the large sloop Robbejacht when she returns. This was done when she returned in the evening and took 50 more. Today we bought 36 head of cattle, young and old, and 11 sheep. Ons het nou 'n klein huisie vol beeste en skape al gekoop oor die laaste paar dae. Man, 'n goeie klomp. Op die 8de December 1655, as maak my Harry kom nou by die fort aan einde van 'n tyd. In the morning, fine weather, breeze from the northwest. The aforementioned sloops returned with the news that of the sheep obtained by barter, 20, which had something the matter with them, had died, and that there now remained 326 all together. So like a klomp skape op Robben Island. Here at the fort we bought another 39 sheep and 27 beasts, young and old. In addition, we have the In addition, we have the 13 brought by Harry for the honorable company. Dit smaak my, Harry is nou terug by die fort en hy 13 beer saam met hom gebring. He reported that he would have brought more cattle had not some natives stolen from him at night 4 bags of copper and all the tobacco, so that he could not trade any more. He had moreover encouraged the natives to come to the fort with their cattle, assuring them that they could always obtain copper here. He did not seem satisfied that all our copper plate had been used for barter, as he said that he had based his negotiations with the other natives upon it. The thick copper wire did not bring much success in the trade, and the thin wire even less. Otherwise, we could have obtained as much as we wanted without any difficulty. It would indeed seem that if we had enough copper plate, we might have obtained at least 1,000 head of cattle. Al het gepraat van hierdie duisende, derduisende, derduisende vee wat hier was. Even from those who squatted here a while and who still come daily without Harry's aid, however, they prefer plate to wire. Okay, dat ons nog wel lang al uitgevind. As to Harry's report and his account of the theft of the copper, we believe half his story to be lies, and that at best he presented it as gifts to the other natives in order to ingratiate himself with them, notwithstanding the fact that the 13 head of cattle are costing the company rather a lot. This would also be a good thing, as we observe that the natives are coming along fairly freely with their cattle. We therefore pretend to believe everything he says, and in addition, treat him very kindly, as much has in the meantime been gained by the establishment of such a good understanding and trade with these uncivilized people. Daar's nog 'n trigger vir vanaand. Okay, hier is nou nog 'n stukkie, dit gaan oor geboorte. Ek gaan hom ook saamlees. The morning the commander Rebek's wife was delivered of her second baby son here at the Cape. And in the afternoon, also the wife of the junior merchant Frederik Verburg of his firstborn, a daughter, the first girl to be born at this place. They had been married exactly 9 months less 1 day. So dit smaak my, die ou het om 'n honeymoon baby gemaak. They had been married exactly 9 months. Ek dink dis dalk hoekom hulle dit so ingeskryf het daar. Hoekom sou hulle geskryf het, ja, maar hulle was presies vir 9 maande getroud gewees voor die kind gebore was. Ek wonder of daar nie dalk 'n backstory is tot hierdie nie. Dink jy dalk dit kon dalk 'n moestrou gewees het? In the evening, the robberjacht returned from Robben Island, reporting that the remaining sheep had been landed on the island and that everything was found to be in order. Okay, hier nog diplomatie. Jong, hier is verskriklik baie diplomatie. Ons nou is by 9de December 1655. In the morning, rainy weather, westerly breeze, as soon as Harry had received back the 3 beasts which had been in our care during his absence, he left for the Cape Falls, stating that he would soon return with other natives and cattle. We wished to take some copper and tobacco. Ek begin weer. He wished to take some copper and tobacco with him again, but as we did not deem this advisable at present for several reasons, we told him that it might again be stolen from him, and that it would therefore be better if he would urge the natives to come to the fort with their cattle. This he promised to do. Time will show with what success. But seeing that this crafty fellow is departing so hurriedly while the others are still trading with us, we firmly believe, as the Carpens and Saldanhamen also allege, that he has been trading for himself with the company's copper, and that he has now become rich in cattle and will no longer care very much about us. Time will soon show. If the said natives continue bringing many head of cattle, our thick copper wire will also soon be running out. But for sheep, we still have an abundance of Indian loyang, or thin wire, which, however, is not popular with these natives, so that no further supplies need ever again be sent from India. Ons soek nie Indiese koper nie, ons soek koperplaat uit die vaderland. Op die 11th, fine dry weather, westerly wind, we obtained 32 sheep for thin copper wire and one beast for thick wire, and would probably have been able to obtain enough. But the natives' eagerness for trade passed, as we had no more copper plate left to give in exchange for cattle. We hope, therefore, that we shall soon obtain a supply from the fatherland as requested by us. So om die persoon se, hulle vra in die boek, in die studiemateriaal wat hulle vir ons kinders leer, hoekom voel julle, dis 'n vraag in die boek, hoekom voel julle, wou die Hottentotte nie vee ruil met die Hollanders nie? En hier kan julle nou sien, dat dit is omdat daar nie genoeg koperplaat was nie. Maar dis is asof hulle so en so in die kinders se koppe, een idee wil laat insink, jy weet, wat ons half nie die waarheid reflekteer nie. En hier is nou nog een Engelse skip, wat hier so aankom. Julle kan maar self daar oor die Engelse skip loop lees. Ons gaan nou, sal ek nog so een paar stukjes raak lees. Hierdie Engelse skip wat hier aangekom het, wat is die dingse naam? Jan Anthanus, or Jan Baptist, of about 100 loss. In elk geval, hulle het die kom kos en goed bedel, en ons het vir hulle gegee, maar dis maak my, hulle het baie gauw oorlaams geraak. Ek gaan daar vir julle los, julle nog wil lees oor die Engelse skip. Ons gaan nou lees oor Dumaan. Dit smaak my, Dumaan gaan een groot rol speel in die boeke wat kom. Maar ek dink voordat ons oor Dumaan beginne lees, gaan ek net weer die oorskakel na die kletskolom toe in een Angie Light vir een smoke break. Wat is dit my maag wat so maak? Ek sien Nero is hierso. Naand klip, eerste keer op die livestream. Goeie naand Nero, ek het jou gesien daarso in die comments seksie. Het jy nou mooi opgevang? Dit is verskriklike baie leeswerk en luisterwerk. Dan ook weer as jy in lockdown is en jy is nie by die werk nie. En niks beter het om te doen nie. En jy wil graag uitvind wat is die waarheid oor wat gebeur het toe Jan van Riebeeck jy aangeland het. Is jy nou op die regte plek, baie welkom by die span Nero. Het ek iets gemis, kom ons gaan net gauw terug. Shaq Dwelle sê, dis blijkbaar die doel van Starlink, cheap internet. Dra net een masker as ek in een winkel ingaan. Dit smaak my amal het vir Cyril Ramaphosa geloop kyk. Dis fijn, jylle kan maar verdwijn. Ok, ek wil hier jylle tyd te veel morsie. Ek gaan hierdie entry so halfpad nip. Nee, ek wil hier eens tip nie. Trek hem aan die koel kraak. Ok, ek gaan hom gauw nip.
Dan lees ons verder. Vir die 9 mense wat gebesluit het om agter te bly. Die eisters. Okay, ek sit hom gewoon weer op die desktop. Kom van het gewoon swing van die water. Mike Simpson sê ons is terug level 1 toe vanaf 12 uur vanaand. Wat beteken dit nou? Kan ons weer heel dag al dag suip? Ek weet nie. Ok, ons gaan nou lees oor diplomatie. Ons gaan hoor vir die eerste keer van 'n persoon met die naam Duman. The natives told us that Harry would never again be inclined to come and serve the honorable company as interpreter. He would, however, be ready to fill his bags with bread, rice, wine, etc. whenever any ships arrive. The copper, they said, had not been stolen from him, but he had obtained many cattle and sheep from the Soldanamen in exchange for it, so that he had now become a great captain and would not care about us any more, as we would notice more and more as time goes on. Hierdie is my net weer eens bevestiging van Harry in die groter, hulle praat van die Eurocentriese perspektief, en dat die geskiedenis moet meer uitgebeeld word uit Harry se perspektief uit. Maar die op die einde van die dag, Harry was eintlik maar 'n niks gewees hier aan die Kaap tussen die plaaslike inboerlinge nie. Harry het sy sukses gekry deur die Hollanders. Ons het vir Harry gemaak om die kooi perspektief uit te beeld volgens Harry se perspektief is juis die Eurocentriese perspektief. Ons moet eerder na the Black Captain dalk kyk. Wat sê ding ookie se naam nou weer? Zwarte Piet. We called aside a certain other Hottentot calling himself Duman or Dumain, a name by which we also now call him because he is such an artless person who seems to be well disposed towards us and together with the Hottentot class thus had been employed in Harry's place as interpreter. As such, he is serving the honorable company better than anybody else, up to the present at any rate. We questioned him in connection with the statements about Harry. He fully corroborated them and added further that it was Harry who had stolen the company's cattle 2 years ago and that his sons had murdered the Dutch boy. Nou, daar's nou so 'n boek met die naam van The Lie of 1652. Nou, binne in hierdie The Lie of 1652, dit smaak my, daar kom nog 'n strafreg episode waar hulle vir Harry gaan straf. En dit, hulle praat van hierdie veediefstal as 'n cold case en Harry het nie gesteel nie en die Hollanders het net probeer frame op Harry. Dit was nooit Harry gewees nie. The Lie of 1652, dit moet verander word na The Lie of 1652. He also explained to us in detail how it had been carried out. When we asked him whether the Karpmans and any others had any hand in it, he answered no, and advanced many arguments to prove how Harry, with his gang alone, had planned and committed the crime, very much, as he said, against the wishes of the Karpmans and the Soldanamen. The Karpmans, though unwilling to part with their cattle, wished always to be our friends and to act as mediators between us and the Soldanamen in trading. If we wished to have proof of all this, he said, we should seize Harry the next time he visited the fort, when he would soon blab out everything and send for his cattle and sheep, for which he has a large number, to regain his liberty. When asked whether, in case we did this, the Soldanamen and the Karpmans would not be angry or run away, fearing that they might share the same fate, he answered no, but that by doing so, we should do them a great favor. They would then be even more inclined to bring more cattle, because
Not a single one of them was kindly disposed towards Harry. As he was such a big talker and was continually carrying false reports from one side to the other. Ek het nou al gesê deur die boek, Harry is 'n 2-6 en hier word nou so half bevestig deur Dumaan en Klaas Das. We might further inquire from the son of the great captain of the Kaapmans. We would then soon find out what Harry was and how all the natives of this country were disposed towards him. Okay, hier is nou 'n interessante stukkie oor parels. Ek gaan ook maar saam lees. Today we sent out 5 men to the southern point of the Bay Falls, where the men had gone with Harry had found some small pearls in mussels, with orders for each to bring back a sackful as a sample for closer examination here. Dis nou natuurlik heel waarskynlik perlemoen. Daan gaans baie se wêreld. Op die 13de Desember 1655 was dit 'n volmaan gewees. In the morning, fine, bright weather, westerly breeze. The Saldanhas again arrived early with cattle and sheep. We bartered from them 89 today, namely 20 old and young beasts and 69 sheep. The Saldanhas came to the fort with many cattle, thinking that we had received a fresh supply of copper plate with the ship, but on seeing that it was an Englishman and that we had received no copper plate, but again appeared with our copper wire, they drove away many of their best cattle again. So daar is nou nog 'n rede hoekom veehandel nie gebeur het nie. Want hier was ons net nie genoeg goed gehad om by hulle te koop nie. Dis maak my hulle kon nou 'n jackpot geslaan het. Harry was also at the fort today, pretending that he had urged these natives to bring their cattle here today, which we feigned in his presence to believe. In the evening, the breeze coming from the southeast, we again dispatched the Robbejag with 77 sheep to the Robben Island, where there will now be a total of 471 sheep. En dit is die meeste skape wat nog ooit hierso was. Kom ek lees gou hierdie stukkie van die Engelse ook by. Die mense wat so bam. The English officers came ashore today to enjoy themselves and dined with the commander at his invitation. They were very short of pot foods on account of the long voyage and earnestly requested some rice, of which we promised to give them 6 tons. Meanwhile, observing our excellent cattle trade with the natives, they also insisted on having another beast or two, whereupon we politely replied that we hoped to be in a position to oblige them. Op die 14de December, in the morning, fine, clear, calm, warm, sunny weather, the natives again brought some livestock, but the trade did not prove as successful as yesterday. We obtained no more than 11 beasts, old and young, and 18 sheep. Nou is nou nog 'n stukkie oor die parels. Kom ek lees maar. The Robbejag returned from the Robben Island after midnight and cast anchor opposite the fort, reporting that the sheep had been carried safely across and that everything was in good order there. Today we obtained 9 head of cattle, old and young, and 10 sheep. Our 5 soldiers who had been sent out also returned today, each with a bag full of the pearl mussels. The pearls were found to be so few and so poor that they were not worth the trouble of collecting, as the surf was heavy where they were found and the mussels had to be gathered at great peril from the rocks. Nou, dit klink vir my baie asof dit perlemoen is. Dit is heel waarskynlik. Ons lees verder oor die diplomasie op die 16de December. 19 sheep were bartered from the natives, but no cattle at all. Since the natives are not keen on copper wire, they also intimated that they intended to wait until ships arrived from Holland with more copper plate, but that they would now and then bring some sheep which would also be acceptable.
So hulle soek net 'n koperplaat.
At about 11 o'clock at night, the newly born child of the wife of the junior merchant Verburg died. In the afternoon, the wind having veered round considerably to the south, the Shallop Robbejacht was sent via the Robben Island to Dassen Island, with orders first to land 50 of the bartered sheep on Robben Island and then to proceed to the Dassen Island there to deliver the commander's letter to the assistant Jan Woutersen, but mainly to find out how the seal catching was progressing and to issue some instructions regarding skinning, etc., as can be pursued in the duplicate book under this date. Only 4 sheep were obtained today, but the natives said that they would bring more tomorrow and every day thereafter. We also received news from our woodcutters that all the Hottentots had already disappeared from sight over the mountains with all their huts and animals. Harry had also departed again.
So daar gaan die klomp beeste, daar hele spul. Hulle gepraat van 20,000 of so aan totaal skape en beeste by mekaar en ook 'n paar duisend, 5,000 or 6,000 mense alself. Hulle is nou al klaar weg. Nou hier is nou die Engelse wat nou bietjie laks kom raak. Julle kan self daar gaan deurlees, ek het tog hierdie stukkie gaan onderstreep.
We told them in all politeness that we had daily given them for refreshment and comfort of their crew as much fruits and greens from the gardens, which are full of them, and they as they wanted, and also that at their former earnest request we had given them 2 cows and 4 sheep, so that with their small crew they had pro rata been better supplied than any of our ships with their large complements had ever been.
So hulle kry meer beter behandeling as die Hollandse skepe, maar die Engelse soek nog. Nou, as jy self daar wil deurlees, hier kan jy nou sien, dan praat hulle so 'n bietjie. Extraordinary insistence. En daar sê Jan van hulle, should please not importune us any further. Dis maak my uit nog sê, daar is vir julle 2 beeste en 2 skape, maar hierdie is nou die laaste. Julle moet nou vir 'n slag julle eie goed begin kry. Nou hier gaan ons nou begin praat oor stamoorloë tussen die kooi. Op die 18de Desember 1655, is dit nou reg? Today 8 head of cattle and 3 sheep were obtained by barter, so that we have now on behalf of the company 332 beasts, young and old, besides more than 520 sheep on the Robben Island. Okay, dit is nou die meeste vee wat ons nog ooit gehad het. Dit is nou selfs meer as wat ons gehad het toe Harry hulle die skape gekom steel, die skaap en bees. Had we but more copper plate, we could easily have brought up to 1,000 beasts. Bought up to 1,000 beasts. Hy praat hier verder oor vryburgers. Wag, hier is nog 'n stukkie wat ek hier raak gelees het.
Yesterday and today 4 beasts and 18 sheep were bought. Ons maak maar daar is nog 'n paar wat inkom, al is die manne nog ver. The total number of sheep at present being about 5,500 and the cattle not far under 3,500, young and old. But as far as pigs, fowls, ducks and geese are concerned, it will be necessary to have freemen to look after them, as it is very difficult to find a suitable person to take charge of the breeding, only clumsy and negligent fellows being available. The gentle folk find it too embarrassing to look after pigs and the like, but freemen would serve the purpose excellently, as all livestock thrive here, as well as crops. And the gentle folks, natuurlijk die aristocracy.
Hier kom ons nou by die oorloë.
Today 18 sheep and 21 head of cattle old and young were obtained by barter. Towards evening, all the Hottentots, even our cooks and wood carriers, left us in order, as they allege, together with the carpents and the aforementioned black captain's people, to make an attack on some Saldana bands. A dispute had arisen between them because the Saldanas had entrusted some of their cattle and sheep to the carpents and the black captain to be sold to us on their behalf. So dis maak my daar was nou 'n onder ons sien. But had heard that twice as much had been paid for the cattle here as the carpents had brought back to them. They had therefore decided to come themselves to the fort to market their cattle. This the carpents, allied with the aforesaid black captain, were endeavouring to prevent, and should a fight ensue, they would try to capture some of the Saldana's beasts. Our cooks, wood carriers, aforesaid hoped to share in this booty, and then to exchange the animals with us for copper. They have us to understand that the carpents also intend doing this. So daar so is oorlog tussen die manne en hulle is gekonkel, almal ses van mekaar. Smaak het my. These activities seem to prove conclusively that the carpents are seeking to keep the natives of the interior away from us, as to secure the profits mainly for themselves. This is not at all a good thing, insofar as the Honorable Company is thereby prevented from discovering what else besides cattle might be obtained from other natives. It would not be strange or quite contrary to expectation, provided the roads of communication were not in this way blocked by the said carpents, if in the course of time people were to come overland to visit us all the way from Monopotapa or Butura. Nou hulle gee hierso Monopotapa and Butura, two cities which were thought to exist somewhere in the interior of South Africa. Ek het dit geloop Google, dit smaak my, dit is by Zimbabwe rond. Hulle gaan hier nanne praat oor Angola en sulke tipe goed ook. Ons was nou daar gewees. Just as, according to the chief of many, they trade with Angola overland and travel from one to the other. Angola's gold is said to come from Monoputapa. Indeed, those of Sofala and Angola are believed to visit each other. We could thus in time expect them here. Also, if only the carpents, as said before, were not such hinderers. Proper attention should therefore be given in this at all times, so that in due course the people from further inland may come to us in safety. At present, however, we must foster and maintain the faith and confidence of the carpents and their allies in us. They daily accuse Harry roundly and urge us to imprison him with his cattle in the fort. Nee meneer, Harry was definitief nie die gouverneur van Robben Island nie. Hy was 'n nul op 'n kontrak in die oë van meeste van die ander plaaslike inboorlinge. As they all say that not only was the Dutch boy murdered by his sons, but that he also stole the cattle. He had enriched himself by procuring cattle with our copper and tobacco, which he untruthfully told us had been stolen from him at night. These were all lies, and it behoved us to inquire more closely and cautiously into all this, but at the same time to continue showing a friendly face. Harry will soon, according to them and to his own statement, come with all his people and cattle to the fort to shelter under our protection. And when this happens, these matters might possibly be revealed further and more clearly. So hulle sien so half in dat in die toekoms gaan Harry weer in die moeilikheid kom by ander mense. Hulle gaan probeer om Harry se vee af te vat, dan gaan Harry weer vlug na die fort toe om onder die beskerming van die kanon te bly.
Dis wat hulle in die toekoms insien. Dit mag dalk so gebeur, dalk nie. Net die tyd sal leer. Meanwhile, it is not at all proper that the Kaapmans should prevent the other inland natives from coming to us, and they should therefore in time be brought under strict discipline so as not to cause so much disadvantage to the honourable company, although they say that they had no hand in the theft of the company's cattle, and that the company's cattle seen among theirs had been taken from Harry. It is nevertheless a fact that we had noticed at the time how hurriedly they left with him, and that they were therefore also guilty. For all this and for hindering the natives from the interior, they deserve to be punished as much as Harry for his frauds. When the opportunity arises, all of this ought to be avenged. It would do no harm, however, first to investigate these matters thoroughly, although we still maintain that we shall not attain any proper understanding or any closer contact with the natives of the far interior until these Kaapmans and their allies, and also Harry, are treated in a different way. Hoor jy nou daar so Domina Morgul? Ons moet hulle op 'n different way hanteer. Domina Morgul het nog nooit van die manier gehou waarop ons hulle hanteer nie. Meanwhile, the Honourable Company is gaining a firm footing here and a thorough knowledge of the relations that exist between the different tribes here. Nou maar die laaste stukkie, thorough knowledge of the relations that exist between the different tribes here. Dit som vanaanse episode perfek op. This will be useful for our future guidance, as we still hope at some time to make acquaintance of and open negotiations with the people of Moniputapa and Butura. But time, more experience and further investigations will be necessary. Op die 23ste het nie veel gebeur nie. Op die 24ste, some of the above mentioned Hottentots returned to the fort, but not at all in such high spirits as they left. It is therefore presumed that they might have hurt their noses somewhat, but they would not admit it, saying that the Saldanhas had gone too far and they had thus turned back. But how much truth there is difficult to tell. Nou maar natuurlik die Kaapmans wou van die Saldanhas se veegeloop afvat het, maar dit smaak my, hulle is sommer gou-gou weer omgedraai. Yesterday and today we bought only 12 sheep and 3 of cattle and 3 head of cattle. At midday the shallop Robbejacht safely from the Dassen Island. Okay, wag, hierdie is nou net van Saldanha. Jy lekker maar daaroor Saldanha loop lees. Kyk hier op die 5 Kersdag 1655. In the morning dry bright weather, wind from the south southeast increasing considerably during the night, and on the 26th it increased steadily with exceptionally strong gusts over the mountain, as a result of which the Englishman's large boat, which had one mast and was riding without a sail on the grapnel near the beach, capsized and ran aground. So, weer die en sê hulle absoluut niks oor Kersfees nie. In 1655 smaak my Kersfees was, dit was net nie 'n ding gewees so wat het vandag is nie. Op die 27ste, the Englishmen very busy trying to refloat their boat, in which they succeeded. Oef, het kon toch. The Englishmen very busy trying to refloat their boat, in which they succeeded, after we had sent, at their request, our sloop Burgoyn to assist them. Nou maar toe, daar die Engelse vraag, hulle soek nog kos en nou. Dis maak met die Engelse raak een bykie van een las. Hier op Jan van Riebeek se rug. Jan van Riebeek wil graag jy, hulle moet nou aanskuif, asseblief. En hierso het Jan van Riebeek het vir hulle 'n rekening gestuur. Daar is die, kom ons net daar, julle kan saamlees. Daar hoeveel reals hy gevra het vir elke, hulle 10 skape en 3 beeste. Man, die Engelsmanne het hulle self grand gehou hier in die Kaap. En daar is nog, jy weet, informatie oor die Engelse, ek gaan nou nie daar oor te veel worry nie, daar op hierdie stukkie praat hulle bykie van Saldanha, julle kan daar ook gaan lees,
na die tyd. Hulle sê tog hierso where there should now be fully 600 skape op Robben Eiland. Nou hier kom ons nou by die laaste afsluiting van diplomatie. Ons trek by die 30ste Desember 1655 in the 31ste jammer. In the morning, cool, rainy, growing weather. Breeze from the northwest. Since the 25th instant, another 2 head of cattle and 45 sheep have been obtained. These were chiefly brought by the Kaapmans, having, according to them, been taken from the Saldanhas. From this same purpose, they and all our cooks, wood carriers, again went out today. Notwithstanding our intimation to them that we would rather they desisted therefrom, in order that the Saldanhas, as well as they themselves, could have access to us. They, however, seemed to pay little attention to this. On the contrary, they insisted on having 6 or 8 strong soldiers with firearms to assist them in robbing the Saldanhas of their cattle, saying that the latter had recently attacked them suddenly and treacherously and carried off many of their cattle, for which they now wish to take revenge. It appears that the Kaapmans are collecting all the forces they can to prevent the Saldanhamen from coming near or to do battle against them. Soos wat het nou vir my lyk is, wel, dit is duidelik geweest, maar dit is nou baie meer duidelik. Die Kaapmans, hulle bly nou onder, jy weet, die beskerming van ons kanon, en dan as mense wil kom veehandel met ons, dan sal hulle in die pad, selfs wat hy die gemaakt het, sê, jy gesels met ons, as daar enige vee geruil word, as jylle 20 koperplate kry, ons vat 10 vir ons, ensovoorts, daar so is, een extra stukkie wat jylle kan lees, tot by oujaars aand, en dan het ons nou so pas, hierdie boekie, Kaf Gedraf. Ek gaan net vir jylle, hier so jylle op die einde, vir die wat meer gewonder het, aan die einde is daar so een stuk oor van Riebeek's Route to the Cape, waar hulle in detail, hier is nou die mense wat mooi geanalyseer het, precies, hoe het die voyage aangegaan. Kom ons het eerste vir julle op die kaart, en ek gaan dit nie deurlees nie, ek gaan dit net so, sê, daar het die reis begin in 1651, hier rondom Kersdag. Daar kan julle sien, daar het hulle met die kus van Afrika opgesel, totdat hulle by die Kanarie-eilande gekom het. En daar van die Kanarie-eilande af, toe druk hulle syd, maar jy sien, die wind druk hulle so half na Brazilse kant toe. En, kan julle hier so sien, dit is, hulle kan breedte lyne, kan hulle uitstekend skat. Daar kan julle sien, hulle was op basis die precieze breedte lyn waar hulle moes, toe hulle besef het, okay, nou moet ons begin oosvaar om by die Kaap uit te kom. Lengte lyne is baie moeilik om te skat. Hulle kon nie daai met baie akkuraatheid skat nie. Sien nie, hier is tot sulke stippel lyntjies waar hulle was nie heeltemal seker waar hulle gegaan het daar so nie. Omdat die aarde draai en dit is baie moeilik om akkuraat tyd te meet, kon hulle nie baie akkuraat sê op wat lengte lyn hulle was nie, maar 'n breedte lyn maak saak hoe die aarde gedraai het nie, 'n breedte lyn lê altyd op die regte plek, so hulle kon baie akkuraat breedte lyne kon hulle uitwerk, maar nie lengte lyne nie, en daar kan julle ook sien. So ek gaan nou net hierdie route, gaan ek so vir die einde, ek gaan net daar so sit vir die mense wat wil na die tyd saamlees. Ek wonder of ek nie hierdie ding in 2 screen grabs kan kry nie. En het lyk my ek gaan 3 moet doen. Vir die ouwens wat wil graag saamlees. Daar praat hulle oor Dutch miles, nou een Hollandse mile en een Engelse mile is 2 heel verskillende goed. Een Hollandse mile is denk 4 of 5 Engelse mile.
Maar dat is baie, baie interessante informatie vir die wat omgee om te lees. Het behoort nie heel aan te vat. O, genade aarde, ek is nou amper 2 ure besig. Amanda Stander sê dankie. Goeienaand Amanda Stander, baie dankie dat jy ook ingeskakel het. En die mense moet natuurlijk nou maar net pause na die tyd, as hulle daar wil saamlees. Oeh, ek wonder hoeveel bladsye is nog hier oor. Dankie meneer vir die reeks, waardeer dit baie. Christo, daar is nog 2 volumes oor. Ons trek nou by episode 22, dit lyk my ons geloop draai by episode 60 of 70. Dit is nie die einde van die reeks nie. Dit is die einde van hierdie een boek. Daar is nog 2 boeke, hier lee, ek het volume 3 hier so langs my, want in volume 3 is daar 'n index. In volume 3 is daar 'n index waar ek goed kan loop naslaan of terugslaan. Dis nog glad nie op 'n einde nie. Ons trek nou by 1655. Van Riebeeck het eers in 1662 die Kaap verlaat. Die boek handel tot op daardie laaste dag wanneer Jan van Riebeeck sy goedjies pak en hy gaan terug na die vaderland. Jan van Riebeeck het sy vrou en kinders gevat, almal terug na die vaderland toe. Ons is nie van Riebeeck se kinders nie. Ons is die mense wie van Riebeeck wat agtergebly het. Ons is die mense wat agtergebly het. Daar is die ou se naam nou. P. Sherton het hierdie analise vir ons gedoen. Sjek dweller, dink ook is moer so interessant. Dit is moer so interessant. Ek het die boek gekry, want ek wou net loop naslaan het. Maar toe ek begin het lees, dit is een boek van avontuur. Vooral met as manne soos Jan Blanks, hulle goed begin het doen. Daar is ook baie mythes wat so gedebank word, beide van die linkse kant en die regse kant. Vir my sê Afrikaners as wetsgehoorsame burgers nie. Is kak daai. Afrikaners is geen wetsgehoorsame burgers nie. As 'n paar stout gatte tussen ons. Ek het vir 'n tyd lank my naam op Twitter gehad. Ek is Jan Blanks. Daarso. Moet ek hierdie boek op auction sit? Met al my notaatjies in. Hy nee, kan hom seker nie dit doen nie. Ek moet actually beter notig, maar elke nou en dan kom daar 'n stryery online. Sê ek, man, ek het hierdie stuk gelees, maar traai jy 'n bietjie control F as jy 'n actual copy van 'n boek het. Dis nie so maklik om goed weer in die hande te kry nie. Kom ek pak hom hier. Ek moet eintlik heeltemal wegpak. En om die boek af te sluit, gaan ek sommer nou vanaand 2 ure stream. Jacques Dwenger sê, my voorvaders het in 1672 met die Keukenhof hier geland. Mense, hier is nou volume 3. Kijk hoe dik is volume 3. Ons gaan nog leer van die oorloë, ons gaan leer van Krotoa, dit smaak my Domaan en Klaas Das, die ouwens, hulle raak groot spelers in hierdie game. Om 'n bietjie ons geskiedenis by mekaar te sit. Kyk wat is die waarheid. Want daar is 'n klomp bullshit wat in die media is. Die een span verteenwoordig die waarheid op. Hulle trek die waarheid heeltemal. Cherry pick net sekere stukke. En die ander span cherry pick ook net sekere stukke. Hier is ons nou by die actual waarheid. En soos ek nou deur al die jare wat ek nou al live streams doen, jy hoor die een span, jy hoor die ander span, dan klink hulle stories heeltemal asof dit nie, nie een van die twee kan waar wees nie. En dan gaan krap jy 'n bietjie, dan kom jy agter die waarheid. Dan besef jy, al twee van hulle praat die waarheid, maar hulle het dit so gecherrypick, dat het klink asof die een heeltemal teenstrijdig is met die ander een, terwyl al twee van hulle actually die waarheid praat. Dit is politiek vir julle. Dit is hartseer maar waar. So ek dit, wanneer sê ook, ek like dit stories oor die keelhole doen. Christo D vraag, kan ons een bywoningssertifikaat kry? Ek kan miskien vir julle een toets opstel. Ek kan vir julle een examen laat skryf, een 20 punt examen. Dan as julle die examen slaag, en nee, dit gaan nie een 25% of een 30% slaagcijfer wees nie. As julle die examen slaag, kan ek vir julle een certificaat print. Dan kan julle het ramen teen julle muur sit. Klipkop certified historian. Hoe sal julle die like? Hoop iemand het die boek gespot. Ek hoor die mense, hulle, ek sien deesda, nadat ek my stel gekoop het, ek weet nie wat daar gebeur het, maar hulle het omtrent 3 of 4 weke gevat, om my stel om, en sê, ja maar, hulle het nou nie meer hierdie kopie, en hulle moet ek, ek sê, ek waar nie nie, wat so kopie hulle vir my krijg, ja maar, dis nou nie meer so nekies, een wat geadverteerd was, ek sê, ek gaan anyway een potlood vat in die boek krap, ek sê net die informatie, ek weet nie wat se toukies die ou in daai kant getrek het nie, maar hulle het 'n volledige stel boek van Jan van Riebeeck geadverteer en ek het hulle gebetaal vir die stel en ek wil vir die oud baie dankie sê dat hy actually vir my toe 'n stel by mekaar kon kry, want dit smaak my van die boeke toe weggeraak en vir my gestuur en ek het so half 'n bietjie my oë oop gehou en daar is nie meer stelle beskikbaar wat jy net kan koop nie, daar is 1 of 2 op auction. As jy wil gaan fundusie hou, kan jy gaan fundusie hou. Ek moet ook nie vir hulle liggie, ek het 'n pretty penny betaal vir die boeke. Maar dit was elke cent werd gewees, elke cent. Dan ook weer 'n pretty penny, dit is omtrent so 'n maand en 'n half se DSTV premium subscription. So dit is seker ook nie so heavy nie. En ek dink as ek al julle manne se memberships by mekaar tel, het ek gedurende die laaste paar maande wat ek die boek lees, het ek dalk my geldjies teruggekry al. Ek wil vir almal sê wat 'n member is, baie, baie dankie. Die manne met die blou en die sexy, goue krone. En dit sal dit wees. Maak die kaptein screen grabs. Post hy dit iewers. Apparently is daar 'n Engelse weergawe PDF beskikbaar. Ek het nog nie te hard genoeg gaan soek nie. Ek moet die PDF's gaan loop soek. As een van julle die PDF's gaan opspoor, ek weet volume 2 is vrylik beskikbaar, maar die ander volume is nie vrylik beskikbaar nie. Mike Simpson sê, ja, tot 12 uur die aand, ok, die smaak met die drinkplekke kan nou tot middernagte oop bly, en die borrelstore normale ure. Mike Simpson sê, net so lang het die oorboektoets is. Mense, ek wil vir julle sê, baie, baie dank dat julle ingeskakel het. Ons het uiteindelik by die einde van volume 1 uitgekom. Weet toch net, daar is absoluut geen skaamte om jou kop uit jou gat te trek nie. Ons moet opstaan vir daardie mense wat vir ons opstaan. En ons is altyd volhard in. Hou koers.